All right, for number five, again, let's go ahead and list out the transformations. I think there are three transformations. Can you list out all three transformations? Okay. Can you list out all three transformations? All right, so what are the transformations? Who can name the first one? Reflection over x-axis. Wonderful. Reflection over x-axis. So that negative here, reflection over the x-axis. What's the next one? Yes. Excellent. Horizontal stretch by, not one-third, by three. It's a reciprocal. Okay, and the last one is to move down by 4 units. Very good, down 4 units. So we'll move down 4 units. Okay, so that means our center of rotational symmetry will be at 0, -4. And then let me write down the boring stuff first here. Okay, and now, so the way we count, since we have a horizontal stretch, we're supposed to go right one. This is also reflection, right? So we have to be a decreasing graph. So we're supposed to move right one and down one, but now with the horizontal stretch, it's going to be moving right three and down one. Moving left three and up one. Okay. And then we go up and down by 7. So to the left, I think it's easy. 3 units again, and up 7 units on the left. And right 3 units and down. So there's something right here beyond the graphing area, but it's okay. Okay, so something like this. And you can clearly see it's not as narrow as what we drew earlier. And that's exactly what's the impact of a horizontal stretch. And, ooh, we have a little question mark right here. What is the x-intercept? That's a good conclusion for today's work. So what is the x-intercept in this case? So we knew that's, we knew about what? Y is zero, right? So we'll go ahead and set y equal to zero. And we will go ahead and find out what x is. Okay, so what's the first step? We're gonna add 4, okay? Because the idea is this. The idea is that we want to get x by itself. So your job is to get rid of things, okay, one at a time from x. So the next thing that we need to get rid of is the, not the cube yet, the negative. Okay, the negative is a little bit farther away from the cube. So -4 and then 1/3 x cubed. Now we take care of the cube by using a cube root, and then we will multiply 3 on both sides, so it becomes 3 times cube root of -4. So the x-intercept is 3 times cube root of -4. Okay. So, please. Whenever the x or the y-intercept is not viewable or it's not something that's a clean cut, you will always go ahead and find it out algebraically so that you have a perfect, exact answer.